Hello, welcome all of you in online classes. In last lecture we talk about the disease Pandu and Kamala according to Ayurveda. Now coming to anemia, it's modern review of Pandu disease. Anemia refers the state in which the level of HB is the blood below normal range, usually defined as a decrease in the amount of red blood cell or hemoglobin in the blood. Can also be defined as a lowered ability of the blood to carry oxygen. Coming to causes, there are different causes according to classics, modern classics. Broadly, may be classified as impaired red blood cell production, increased RBC destruction, blood loss, and fluid overload. Mainly, we can classify in these headings. For coming to impaired production, anemia of renal failure by insufficiency erythropoietic production, vitamin B12 deficiency, anemia of folic acid deficiency, iron deficiency anemia resulting in deficiency heme synthesis, increased destructions, anemia of increased red blood cell destruction are generally classified as hemolytic anemia. These are generally featuring jaundice, sickle cell anemia. Due to the blood loss, anemia from recurrent blood sampling for laboratory testing, trauma or surgery causing acute blood loss, gastrointestinal tract lesion causing either acute bleed, example like peptic ulcer or chronic blood loss, from menstrual, mostly among young women or elder women who have fibroids. In pregnancy also it happens anemia. Infection by intestinal nematodes feeding on blood such as hookworms. Another clause, fluid overload. Fluid overload causes decreased hemoglobin concentration and apparent anemia. General causes of hypovolemia include excessive sodium or fluid intake, sodium or water retention. Signs and symptoms of this disease. Mainly signs are undetected in mainly anemia is undetected in many people, and symptoms can be minor: weakness, fatigue, general malaise, lethargy, sometimes poor concentration, dyspnea, shortness of breath on exertion, ankle swelling. In the case of severe anemia, the body may be compensate for the lack of oxygen carrying capacity of the blood by increased cardiac output, may possibility of palpitation, angina if pre-existing heart disease is present, intermittent claudication of the lungs, pale skin, lining mucosa, conjunctiva and nail beds. It is the main places of observation. There may be sign of specific cause of anemia like choelonychia in iron deficiency anemia at present. Jaundice, when anemia results from abnormal breakdown of the red blood cell in hemolytic anemia. Samhita grantho mein bhi jo ek quotation diya hai, pandrogi tu yatyatham pitlani ni sevate tasya pitam asrugai asrugmashay दग्ध्वारोगाय कल्पत. तो जो पांडुरोग के बाद एज अ कॉम्प्लिकेशन जॉइंटिस होता है, तो उसमें भी ये बताया गया, व्हेन एनीमिया रिजल्ट फ्रॉम एबनॉर्मल ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ रेड ब्लड सेल, जो कि हीमोलाइटिक एनीमिया है. ठीक है, In severe anemia, tachycardia, a fast heart rate, and cardiac ventricular hypertrophy, enlargement is present. Maybe. Now coming to type according to red blood cell. In the morphological approach, anemia is classified by the size of red blood cells. This is either done automatically or on microscopic examination of a peripheral blood smear. If the cells are smaller than normal, the anemia is said to be microcytic. If they are normal size, normocytic. If they are longer than normal, an anemia is classified as macrocytic. Another one type, dimorphic. A dimorphic appearance on a peripheral blood smear occurs when there are two simultaneous populations of red blood cells, typically of different size and hemoglobin content. For example, a person recently transfused for iron deficiency would have small pale iron deficiency red blood cell and the donor RBCs of normal size and color. This is the dimorphic condition. Other one is sickle cell disease. Is a group of blood disorder typically inherited from a person's parents. The most common type of is known as sickle cell anemia. It results is an abnormality in the oxygen carrying protein hemoglobin found in red blood cells. This is the picture of sickle cell anemia shape of red blood RBC. This lead to a rigid sickle cell shaped under certain circumstances. Next one is hemolytic anemia. Is a condition in which red blood cells are destroyed and removed from the bloodstream before their normal lifespan is over. Red blood cells are disc-shaped and without holes in the center. Causes. Iske cause kya kya ho sakte? Defect of red blood cell membrane, defect in hemoglobin, defect red blood metabolism. This is the normal cell, blood cell and hemolytic blood cell, hemolytic anemia cell, destruction of RBC is there, you can see. Another one condition is thalamia major. Thalamia major occurs when a child inherits two mutated genes, one from each parent's. Children born with thalamia major usually develop the symptoms of severe anemia within the first year of life. They lack the ability to produce normal adult hemoglobin and experience chronic fatigue. There is another one is thalassemia minor. The hemoglobin genes are inherited during conception, one from the mother and one from the father's sperm. People with a thalassemia trait is one gene are known as carriers or are said to have thalassemia minor. Another one condition is mean corpuscle volume or mean cell volume is a measure of the average volume of a red blood corpuscle or red blood cell. If its value high means MCV is high, then it causes macrocytic anemia. In the condition of microcytic anemia, MCV is low. The mean corpuscle or hemoglobin. MCH, mean corpuscle hemoglobin, is the average mass of hemoglobin per red blood cell in a sample of blood. MCH value is diminished in hyperchromic anemia. It is calculated by dividing the total mass of hemoglobin by the number of the red cell in a volume of blood. MCH is equal to HB by RBC. The mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. A measure of a concentration of hemoglobin is a given volume of packed red blood cell. It is reported as a part of a standard complete blood count. MCHC is equal to MCH by MCV. Now coming to treatment portion. According to modern, treatment of the anemia depends on the various causes and severity. First of all is iron, oral iron supplement. Nutrition iron deficiency is common in developing nations. An estimated 2/3 of the children and of women of childbearing age in most developing nations are estimated to suffer from iron deficiency anemia. Mild to moderate iron deficiency anemia is treated by oral iron supplement with ferrous sulfate, ferrous fumarate, or ferrous gluconate. When taking the iron supplement, stomach upset or darkening of the faces are commonly experienced. The stomach upset can be alleviated by taking the iron with food. However, this decreases the amount of iron absorption. Vitamin C aids in the body ability to absorb iron, so taking oral iron supplement with orange juice is of benefit. Injectable iron supplement. In cases where our oral iron has either proven ineffective, would be too slow, for example preoperative, or where absorption is impaired, for example in cases of inflammation, parenteral iron can be used. The body can absorb up to 6 mg iron daily from the gastrointestinal tract. In many cases, the patient has a deficit of over 1000 mg of iron, which would require severe months to replace. Blood transfusion. If injectable or oral iron is not proven its efficacy, then blood transfusion is in those without symptoms is not recommended until the hemoglobin is below 6 to 8 gram per day. Erythropoiesis stimulating agent. This would not be used for mild or moderate anemia. They are not recommended in people with chronic kidney diseases unless hemoglobin level are less than 10 gram per dl or they have symptoms of anemia. Thank you. Thank you so much.